stuff like that. And he's trying to figure it out. You guys,
welcome back. Yeah, we're just gonna continue where we left off. So I did do some experimentation. I kind of figured, or I kind of found out that the game actually crashes if you try to do a bonding event and then you finish that bonding event. Like, it straight up just crashes 100%. So right now, that issue that I was describing, I've only tested Asuna's event, or Asuna's event. So I don't know if. Alright, let's since Medina is the. Give her a samurai. Make her a buffer.
Huh?
It's there. I can see it. Come on.
Yes.
Please don't tell me it actually freezes the game too. Oh boy. Oh, come on. No way. Okay. I thought it froze the game.
Huh?
Out of context, it's so like weird.
ありがとう。どういたしまして。お。さてと。だけど。そういえば。あ。この音は何か緊急の。
以上がベルクーリ騎士長からの伝令です。魔獣と指令は受け取りました。それではお願いします。
では早速。
ああ、急ごう。
困ったな。なんだい、頼む、はい、ありがとう。どうも。頼みたい。よろしく。ありがとう。はい、よろしく。
なぜ？
はい、ありがとう。ありがとう。行くよ。
行くぞ。
困ったな。どうも。はい。うん。あの、はい。任せ。ありがとう。なあ。はあ。よろしく。
Yeah!
ども。はい。はあ。ありがとう。はい。
頼んでもいいで、
うん、
なあ、
任せ、
ありがとう。はい、よろしくな。
何？どうしよう。ねえ、はい。ふう、助けてください。ありがとう。
Just gather them up. Oh, we're pretty much gonna. We're gonna do one of them. Like by accident, probably.
Domo.
I think I'm already done with this quest. Yeah, we have it. Yeah, let's give it to you.
Arigato ne. Arigato ne.
That. Oh, god damn it. I could have just taken a shortcut. It'd be nice if it's marked on the map. Is it? Because I can. If it's marked. Oh shit, yeah. There we go. Okay.
お疲れ様。
終わったな。
Okay, so it's a lot better than Fatal Glory. I have to warn you, there are some bugs that I've actually encountered already. Like, some of the character events, right now I've just tried it with the Asuna event. It just freezes. It's literally just freezing. So, I mean, the combat mechanics is a lot more fun to use. So, I mean, if you can get it at a low price, like a discount, feel free to try it out. Don't pay full price for it. I don't think at the moment it's still worth that price, just because, like, the bugs I encountered is a literal freeze, and I haven't seen a fix for it. So, and if you're into Monster Hunter games, it's an easy sell, honestly. Like, it feels like it's a lot closer to Monster Hunter. Thank you. Hopefully that helps. I haven't I haven't tried co-op yet, so I can't answer the co-op. That's the thing, I don't play a lot of co-op games. Honestly, I'm playing this more for the just for completion's sake. I'm trying to just complete like the story. So yeah, I mean, I haven't tried the online component, but mechanically it's fun. Again, it's a lot closer to Monster Hunter than any SAO games I've played. Like, I played Hollow Realization, Lost Song, Fatal Bullet, and yeah, this is so far the most polished one out of the SAO games. But again, it has a lot of issues at the moment, so I can't recommend it at full price, like I said. So yeah, I mean, if you want to get it for your get it for yourself first, play the game, and then, you know, maybe you can invite your buddies and like try out the mechanics with them. Big warning though, it takes about 10 hours to get to the co-op, because you have to, like, I think reach chapter 2? Yeah, 2-1. You have to finish 2-1 to actually get to the co-op section, or be able to add co-op. But yeah, that's my 2 cents on it.
あの、ん?なんだ、あんたら、俺たちは、氷境界から派遣されてきたんです。この近くに、強力な魔獣が出るから、討伐してくれと。おう、そうなん、ちょうど、俺たちで、なるほど。私の武功が。話では、魔獣は、まあ、それなりに自信。まさか。ああ、俺たちをそうよ、目覚めてからどうすればいいかわからなかったが、そこで、同じ境遇の、 生まれながらの戦士とはいえ、あなたたち、ここから少し行った場所にいる魔獣でな。だがあまりの強さに敗走して、その魔獣が俺たちの探し、みたいだな。いえ、構わないわけな。そうか、お詫びと言っちゃなんだが。本当か。だが一つ条件がある。討伐へは俺たちも混ぜてくれ。Yeah,
Hopefully, I've been hearing a lot of things about Art. Not all of them good, but yeah, I mean, give it a shot. Hopefully, you again, if you once you grab the disc, if you can get it at a low price, do it, and hopefully you have fun. Again, the mechanics is the one that pretty much kind. The story is bullshit, to be honest. Like, just feel free to skip the story stuff because there's a lot of cheesy dialogue and all that crap in there that you can just ignore and just go straight for the combat. And once you kind of get used to the combat, it's a lot more fun that way. Because again, it's an SAO story, so you know what that entails. if you've seen SAO, then yeah, you kind of know what that entails. And also, to be honest, the AI is not, it's not actually incompetent. The AI is not bad. I'm going to tell you that right now. These AIs are actually pulling their weight. And, you know, they're not just running into the enemy. They can actually dodge, block. they actually do dodge and block. So, if anything, the bots are pretty good. Helping Oh, yeah, sure. I'll drop my PSN into the chat.
って呼ばれるものだと思う。互いの手のひらをぶつけて勝利を喜び合うんだよ。
現実世界の記憶を。お嬢ちゃんも見事だったぜ。
また共闘できる。わかった。なぜ私をそう呼ぶ。さて、引き続き魔獣討伐。それが俺たちの使命だ。行こうぜ。
All right, thanks, man. Appreciate it.
Medina?
Those awkward camera angles, dude. Like, it's hilarious when they do like weird camera angles. Like very inappropriate camera angles.
オートまでは距離もあるし。なんだ、ユージオ。お腹空いたのか。そうじゃなくてさ、今の戦いで薬なんか。ユージオの言う通りですね。な、それと。
No, I think they were they're trying to make like that, you know that those anime angles where they try to zoom in on the mouth and you know, make it more menacing with the smile, with the weird like anime crazy smile. But they kind of like not zoomed in too much, so now it it kind of focuses on the administrator's chest. So like, oh come on, man. Oh boy, that was hilarious though. That was like unexpectedly hilarious moment. Okay. Uploaded by other players known as play avatars. When your own uploaded play avatar goes on an adventure in another player's world, you can sometimes earn rewards for it. Rewards being length of time spent and tasks on the play avatar. Uploading and updating requires enough attention. Okay. Huh. Okay. That's interesting. So, it kinda, that mechanic actually resembles, Dragon's Dogma. That weird ass, I forgot the name of the type, but yeah, that weird ass. Alright, let me upload my avatar. That weird ass, like, weird character? Yeah, they, honestly, again, it's good that they've learned a lot of their lessons, because, honestly, Hollow Realization was kind of shit. Like, the mechanics was super clunky and everything. So was Lost Song. I think Lost Song was worse than Hollow Realization. And, the Fatal Bullet is an improvement, just because, like, the shooting is fine, and you actually get to play an original character. I think on Fatal Bullet, you play as, like, your own custom character. Yeah, and Hollow, this one is the latest one, so this one is fine. It's actually closer to, again, Monster Hunter. Alright. actually changes the entire look. So the story. So, I think, okay, so I think another, I don't know if this particular thing is, or this particular feature was on Fatal Bullet, but I think this is the first SAO you can actually romance the male character, oddly enough. Yeah. You can increase the affection rating. You can do all this with DJO. So, yeah, it's super different than it's again. It's the latest one. So, hey, okay. I mean they're more progressive, I guess. I think yeah, but yeah, that is the first SAO I've seen that did that.
Domo.
Wait, what? Oh, dude, am I freaking giving him hard slates? That's true. I mean, who needs fanfiction, right? Now that you can, that you have these games. Oh boy, those Fujoshi and Doujinshi artists are gonna go insane with this game. And they can even create their own OC, no matter what the gender, and then like literally romance any of the main characters. So like who needs doujinshi? SAO doujinshi. Oh, also, if you are playing on the PS, on the PlayStation, yeah, they didn't do any improvements on the loading time, nor the frame rate. So if you do have a strong PC, I kind of recommend getting it on the PC, just so at least you can get more frames out of it. Oh, boy. But yeah, if you can get it on the PC, get it on the PC. So if you notice the footage, it's running at 30 frames. Sometimes it actually depends on what's going on the screen. It does go down to sub 40 or sub 30. It kind of sucks that even on the PS5, they didn't do any optimizations for it. Like, even the load time is pretty bad. The load times are actually atrocious. The good thing about it is the areas are pretty big, so I guess that's a plus, but I wish they really optimized this for the PS5 once they created like a DLC or a patch for it for PS5. Just so you have a better frame rate for it. But yeah, otherwise you're stuck with pretty much 30 to sub 30 So yeah, I mean, plus you get the mods you get the additional benefits of modding on the PC. And I think from another person earlier, I was talking with them about this. They did mention the requirement on the PC is a 1080. The minimum. I'm not sure if it's the minimum or if it's the required. But you need an RTX 1080. In the very least. For this to work. But yeah, that's it is pretty steep considering with the current situation for GPU if you are gonna assemble a new computer. But if you don't mind playing on 30 frames or 30 FPS or kind of the bad loading times, if you don't mind those, then yeah, go for like console version. The only reason I'm telling you this is because it does become a deal breaker for some people sometimes. Playing at sub 30 or playing at a lower frame rate. The only reason I kind of kept with this is because I already have a copy, so might as well just play with it. And then once I'm done, if I really want to move forward with this game, I'll probably buy the PC version, then you can probably mod the shit out of it and do the unlock frames. See, the loading time is pretty atrocious. And this is on a PS5. I haven't seen the Xbox app. Did they release a patch for the Xbox, the Xbox S? Because yeah, the loading didn't improve on this one, so I don't know, maybe we will get a patch on the PS5. I don't know when the last one, actually, that's pretty awesome. So the last patch was on 1.3. And it was released on February. Okay. So yeah, also, there, like, I think one of my buddies was asking why I didn't go with the dual wield, like the default weapon for Kirito. It's honestly because of this move for the katana. You actually get a judgment cut. It's a legit judgment cut. And it has a dodge on it, so it's like a... If you played Metal Gear Rising, it's like a combination of Virgil's, Raiden's, dodge cut and, Virgil's judgment cut. Plus, it's a legit zoning tool. They're kind of like on the higher levels, they kind of become, I hate it, but they kind of become damage sponge, like at a higher level. So one of the anyway, like if I get a chance, I'll show you like one of the hunts. I think I was fighting a level 50 hunting target. I'm at level 35. You can fight them at that level, but it takes a long, it becomes a long ass fight, and yeah, it's not like an easy, actually here, let me save, and I can, it's a quick cunt, savage nature, let's see. See if we can do a quick hunt. And the main problem with that is it's not like they're hidden. Like, some of these enemies just appear random parts of the field. I mean, you'll see them. It's not like, again, it's a surprise. Like, you know, it's gonna surprise you in the back, but... Okay, for this one, let's see what... I can't remember what level this guy is. Alright, yeah, so this is a hunt. Okay, so it's not even, yeah, it's not even high level. But yeah, these are, if you notice, like, the bar, I'm already at super, I'm pretty over level at this point of the story. But yeah, they kind of become advantage for this. Like, look at the, so if you see how much damage I'm doing per slice, or per hit. Okay, it's going a lot faster just because, like, I'm way above the... Oh, there you go. Yeah, I'm already way above. Let's see if I can find a more... stronger hunt. Yeah, this didn't take too long. Let's see. Okay, there's one here. All right, let's I think I can do this one. This one's the closest. Yeah, all right, this one. All right, so this guy is level 50, so he's about 14 levels above me. These are like, if you become near a certain amount or a certain number of levels above, they legit become damage sponges. But the problem is, like, you can encounter them pretty quickly, and if you encounter them at super low level and you try to fight them, they can actually one-shot you. So not only are they damage sponges, they're legit pretty tough. I mean, you can beat them. Like, you can actually beat these guys as long as you have sufficient level. Like, again, I'm 14 levels below this guy, and you can still get him as long as you have the proper skills and you can dodge, because dodging is actually, it's not perfect, but it works kinda. Have limit breaks as well. Yeah. It actually, it's pretty good mechanically, just because I think every time you do it, it does improve your, like, kind of relationship with all the Otsi. It actually went up from, I think the last time was 6%. The character affection does go up with that. So mechanically, it does make sense. It does work. So, and here's the skill tree. Oh, also, one, I hate this. This is like one of the worst way they could have implemented the skill tree. So, let's see if I can find it. Okay, so let's say, let's add a, I'm trying to look for a party member that I can add. Okay, so here. Sardalina. So if you notice on the skill tree, there's no skill tree for heavy sword, for two-handed swords. So like the rapier's here, this is one hand sword, this is one-handed, this is the dual wield, this is the bow, and this is the katana, and this is the mace. So I have so one of the characters I have right now is Sordalina, which her main weapon is heavy sword, two-handed sword. So right now, even though if I want her to like learn more skills, she doesn't have any, and I can't. So the only way you can unlock that tree, even though she already has a two-handed weapon equipped, is to unequip her weapon, equip another one, and there you go. It unlocks the skill tree if you like change the weapon into like the two-handed sword weapon. So now when you look at it, there you go. Now there's another skill tree here. There you go. The two-handed sword. It's so dumb how they implemented this. Like if you have, that's like if you already have party members that could equip this particular weapon, there should be no reason why they locked it. It's insane. Like, that is such a bad design. So earlier, I was having this issue earlier because I was trying to, I actually added Asuna to my party, and I was trying to learn more skills for her, but I couldn't find the rapier skill tree. And I just kind of fumbled on discovering this particular mechanic. It's such a bad design for its skill tree. So like this one, if I want the whip parts to unlock, I gotta equip Savage Whiptail. There you go. So yeah, like I again, it's a weird way to actually implement a skill tree. Exactly. and one of the characters already has a two-handed weapon, so it's such an odd design. Oh, damn it. Oh, there you go. Other guys. the other guys is there you go. So this the other character or the other characters that the other players have uploaded. And I think it does filter. I don't know if it's a. Oh, you can actually do friends. Oh, okay, there you go. So there are restrictions for matchmaking. You can do a quick match, but I think it's still. Yeah, it still needs the proper game version. Oops. Yeah, I don't know. I still need to review what the quick match actually does. But yeah, the matchmaking kind of has a bunch of restrictions in there. So yeah, I have to look into how quick match actually works.
Let's go.
Thanks, man. Have a good night. Do this last hunt for the night. Thank you. Sweet.
Thank you. Yeah. Is pretty fun actually. Damn it. Oh, nice. We can wrap it up for tonight. As soon as it loads. There you Oh, come
on. Domo.
Yare, yare.
Daga. Sore to.
Ii na.
Sore wa. Sore to.
Naruhodo. Arigato ne.
Ah.
All right. Thanks. thanks for hanging out, guys. And, yeah, we'll wrap it up from here. See ya.